If you're looking for some great Father's Day gift ideas for the hunter in your life, I've got you covered. Hey guys, I'm Junie the Orange Huntress, and welcome back to my channel where we bring the hunt home and the wild inside. Today I'm going to share with you 20 gift ideas for the hunter in your life for under $50. I've got some insight from my hubby Curtis, who has been around hunting his whole life and is a great dad to my three kids, so why wouldn't I ask for his input on things that he would want for Father's Day? It's a really good idea to get some input. All the items I talk about today are going to be down in the description below. I have no affiliate links, so this is honestly just for information and inspiration for you. If you can find things local, do that, because hashtag support local around here. Here's my list of 20 gift ideas for under $50. First one, jerky. Not only is jerky packed with protein, it has amazing flavor as well. You can get a lot of different types of jerky. Beef jerky, you can get chicken or turkey jerky. We've also made venison jerky, and I'll leave a link down in the description below if you want to watch our venison jerky video. But jerky is such a great thing to have in the field, whether you're driving around in the truck trying to find your deer, or whether you're waiting in the bush for your perfect animal to appear. Jerky is a great tasting snack and easy to enjoy just about anywhere. Silicone wedding ring. Curtis has had his silicone wedding ring for the past, 7 years or so. We got it when he was lifting weights. It is really durable and flexible. So if your hunter was in the bush and jammed his finger, he could easily remove it without having it cause permanent damage. They come in a lot of different sizes and styles, so you can choose the perfect one for your man. Camouflage bow tie. I don't know about you, but I think bow ties are so cool. My husband loves to wear them as opposed to a normal long tie. I found some really cool ones on Etsy, and she actually makes them in smaller sizes as well, not just for adults. Can you just imagine the cutest Father's Day picture with all your little men in bow ties? I can. A deer call. This is really an essential tool when you're out hunting, and the one I have linked down below is really good because it's good for beginners. It can make 3 different calls for whatever type of deer you need to call in. Then it's really versatile for that. Coffee. I know this doesn't apply to everyone, but I found this really cool coffee brand online, and they're veteran owned. They have some really cool names for their coffee. The cool thing too is they roast 5 days a week. So when they ship their coffee out, it's the freshest that it can be. You don't have to buy coffee from this company, but I thought that their Flying Elk coffee looked pretty awesome for hunters. Hand warmers. If you live in Canada or anywhere more north, you understand that keeping your hands and appendages warm is super vital. My husband runs hot most of the time, but honestly, like when he's out hunting, he can get pretty chilly. These hand warmers are the ones that we always use. They have a 7-hour lifespan to them. I like how thin they are, so you can slip them into a glove and keep your hand warm that way. Gloves. Good gloves are essential when you're out in the field, especially when you are pulling that deer back to your truck. Finding some gloves that have some good durable leather in the hands is a great idea. And before you start pulling your deer back to your vehicle, you can just slip a hot pack in to help you stay warm. I listed some gloves down below. There are 5 different colors and a couple different sizes to choose from, so you've got some options for your hunter. A beard kit. This is all the rage, or has been over the past few years, is to have a beard. Mine definitely does. We try and keep his beard and mustache nice and trim and tidy, especially when he's taking those gotcha pictures with his animal. Beard oils and beard balms help to moisturize the skin and the hair to keep it from getting dry. Hunting books. Now you can get more literature where people are telling their stories about hunting, or you can get things that talk more about how to butcher and how to cure meat. I'm going to list a couple down below to choose from. I haven't read too many myself, but my husband has kind of read a couple, so I'm going to get his input on which ones he thinks would be the best for you guys. T-shirts. Now, I don't just mean like Cabela's or a picture of deer antlers, which are all fine, but you gotta get something cheesy. Why not? It's Father's Day. There are some things that just need to be done. Cheese needs to be had. I'll link a couple of my favorites down below. The one my husband is wearing is from Meat Eater. They also have some really fun options too. Targets for target practice. Working on your aim before you go out hunting is vital, and this is one way to ensure that your hunter is going to bring home meat. It's so satisfying when you hear the ping of the bullets on the metal, and you don't have to wonder, where did it actually hit? If you want, you can get paper targets as well. The one I linked down below is good for the calibers 22 and higher. Monocular chest strap. My husband loves the one that he picked up last year. It actually has a pouch. Some of them are just clip-ons for your binoculars. And depending on the one you get, you can attach your rangefinder to it as well. A meat eater tumbler. They use Yeti tumblers that are stainless steel. I got a Yeti tumbler for Christmas this last year and love it. My coffee stays hot for like 6 hours. It's insane. I never had expected that. The only thing is, if you tip it over, it will spill out a little bit. But honestly, for heat retention or cold retention, they are a dream. A personalized Father's Day mug. This can be something that your kids put together themselves, or you can find really cool designs online. I've linked one down below I thought was super cute. If your kids are anything like mine, they love giving personalized presents to their dad on Father's Day. A meat eater cookbook. You can really find any hunting or angling cookbook, but we love our meat eater cookbook. And Steve Rinell signed it himself, which I think is so cool. There are so many recipes in there, I think over 100, with spices that I had not been familiar with. So it really helped to enhance our range of seasonings. And it's been a really good experience using that cookbook so far. Compression socks. I know a lot of hunters just wear good woolly socks, but when I was talking to Curtis, he said compression socks are key. Not only do they stay up really well, the compression socks that I've found down below have a padded foot, they wick away moisture, they control odor, they're thermoregulating, so they're good for long seasons of use. A hunting hat. You can find many hunting hats online, whether they have antlers on them or a funny logo or cool stitching patterns. This is a cool way to keep your hunter looking fly and protected from the sun. An engraved wallet. The one I posted down below is made of faux leather, and they have a lot of different ideas for what you can inscribe inside, or you can actually customize your own message to your hunter. How awesome is that? That every day he goes to use his wallet, he will be reminded of the love of his family. A bow release. This is a great idea if your hunter is into archery. They attach really securely around the wrist. It takes the pressure off your hunter's fingers as they're drawing back the bow. The one that Curtis uses has a 60-pound draw weight and a feather light trigger release. There are some that you can release with your thumb as well. This is definitely a great idea to make bow hunting just that little bit easier. Scent eliminator spray. We use a scent eliminator detergent on our hunting clothes before we head out into the field, but there are others that you can spray on when you're out in the field. What these are really good for is they destroy odor and make your hunter undetectable to the prey that they're stalking. Now that you've got some ideas for the hunter in your life, let me know down below which one was your favorite. Honestly, the tumbler, hands down, my favorite. And don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll catch you next Wednesday.